Hello, everybody. Welcome to Chapter 2 of The Secret Valentine. This chapter is called Clues and More Clues. Miella didn't waste any time on the school bus Monday morning. "Did you bring the Valentine?" she asked. "Stop calling it a Valentine," I complained. "It's a clue." Miella took the note from my hand and read it over again. She wasn't in a hurry. "What do you think?" I asked. "Well," Miella said, "she's not a very good speller." Miella pointed to the words, "secret and admirer and Gus." "Look," Miella said, "they are spelled wrong." I took her word for it. "But I'm wondering why she cut out letters from a magazine," Miella said. "Why didn't she just write it?" "Everyone's handwriting is like a fingerprint," I answered. "She didn't want to leave a clue." Then I smiled. "But everybody leaves clues. You just have to know where to look." Miella pulled on her long black hair. "The paper is a clue," she said. "This is the same kind of paper we use for homework. The paper was grayish with red and blue lines. Miss Gleason made us do all our homework on the same kind of paper." "Maybe it's a girl in our class," I said. "It must be," Miella said, "or else she wouldn't have bothered to hide her handwriting. I had liked school before this. Sure, it wasn't a cool lake on a summer day, but school was all right." "Not anymore. How could I sit in a classroom knowing that some girl liked me? Wherever I went, two eyes would follow me. Yeesh, it gave me the creeps." After taking attendance in room 201, Miss Gleason made a special announcement. "As you know, Friday is Valentine's Day." Everybody cheered. Valentine's Day was almost as popular as Halloween. Miss Gleason pointed to a big box on the work table. It was decorated with wrapping paper and hearts. "This is our post office," she said. "You have all week to bring in your Valentine cards. I'll assign mail carriers to deliver the cards on Friday." Everybody sat up straight. We all tried to look like expert mail carriers. I noticed Biggs Maloney flash a big smile at Lucy Hiller. Poor Biggs. Lucy had turned our class tough guy into a teddy bear. I looked at the other girls in room 201. Who could it be? Who had sent me the secret Valentine? "Boys, girls," Miss Gleason said, "I know you are all very, very excited. Let me remind you how this works. There are three rules. Number one, you must send a Valentine to every child in the class. Last week, I gave you all a class roster to bring home to your parents. Don't forget anyone. Rule number two, you must do your own work. I don't want your parents filling out the cards for you." Ralphie Jordan snapped his fingers. "Rats!" Miss Gleason smiled at Ralphie's joke. "Third, every card must say to and from. Try to be good letter writers." During reading circle, Miss Gleason read from a book called Abraham Lincoln. We had started it last week. It was a long book, so we couldn't read it all in one day. Anyway, I learned another interesting fact about Honest Abe. I wrote it down. Abe kept important papers in his hat. Six more facts to go. The more I learned about Abraham Lincoln, the more I liked him. He was smart and strong. That's pretty good, even if he didn't play in the NBA. At the end of school, we got our coats and hats and lined up at the door. I felt something in my pocket, something that wasn't there this morning. It was an envelope. Inside, there were two pieces of heart candy. One said, "Be mine." The other said, "You're sweet." They were both green. There was a note, too. It said, "Theodore, nobody, how much I love you. I crumpled up the note. I was going to throw it in the garbage. Then I remembered it was a clue. I had to save it. Suddenly, Bobby Solovsky grabbed the note from my hand. What are you reading, Theodore? He said. I tried to grab it back, but Bobby handed it to his best friend, Mike Radcliffe. Read it, Mike, Bobby said. Mike did, out loud. Jigsaw has a secret Valentine, he teased. Everybody giggled. Bobby Solovsky laughed so loud I thought his head was going to fall off. I wish it had. I hate teasers.